Hello guys, what's up? Hope you are doing good. In this video, we will going to discuss about the classification of goods and services under GST. In this, we will cover the topic about the need for classification of goods and services under GST. And then we will cover about the background of HSN code list. HSN stands for Harmonized System of Nomenclature. It is a list which is adopted by almost 200 countries to unify the classification of goods and services under their countries. And then we will cover about the section, chapter and description or heading in HSN list. HSN list is divided into different segments. First segment is a section. Second segment is about the chapter, and third one about the heading. What exactly is section, heading and chapter? We will discuss under this topic. And then finally, we will cover about how to interpret the HSN code list. In this, we will cover the rules for interpretation of HSN code list. Like if you want to classify your goods and services under GST or under any other law, then how to classify your goods and services under this list, because there is a set of rules to follow before classify the goods and services under GST. So in this, we will cover the rule and the interpretation of HSN code list. So now first we should discuss about the need for classification of goods and services under GST. So why do we need to classify goods and services under GST? Let's face it, there are lots of goods and services existing on this planet Earth. So it is not possible to specify the one common GST rate for all the goods and services. And it is also impossible to list down all the goods and services and specify the GST rate against all of those goods and services. So the only option left is to classify the goods and services into groups and subgroup and specify the GST rate against each of those group and subgroup. The most scientific way to classifying goods is on the basis of HSN. The HSN classification is also used in foreign trade policy, central excise and customs. And in some of the states, some part of the HSN is also used in their VAT laws. The common classification will also help in reducing the transaction cost and also help in reducing the diversion of classification amongst different agencies. So the most scientific way is to classify the goods under the HSN, and under GST the goods will also be classified on the basis of HSN. So there are no other scientific way on the basis of which the classification of goods and services can be done. HSN stands for Harmonized System of Nomenclature. It was developed by the World Customs Organization. As the international trade increased, the need was felt to have a universal standard system of classification of goods to facilitate the trade flow and the analysis of trade static. This is an international nomenclature standard which is adopted by about 200 countries to have the uniformity in classification of goods in international trade. And almost 98% of the merchandise in international trade is classified on the basis of WCO website. WCO stands for World Customs Organization website, and the website is www.wcoomd.org. HSN list is divided into sections, chapters and headings. Sections are the grouping of number of chapters which codify a particular class of group. And each of the sections is related to a broader class of goods. For example, section 1 is related to the animal product. Section 2 is related to the vegetable product. And section 15 is related to the base metal and the article of base metal. Section notes are given at the beginning of each section, which governs the entry in that section. These notes are applicable to all the chapters in that section. After sections, then comes the chapter. Each of the sections is divided into different chapters, and each chapter contains the particular class of goods. For example, section 15, which is of base metal and article of base metal, is divided into the different chapters, like chapter 72, chapter 73, chapter 74, chapter 75, etc. And each chapter contains the particular class of goods. For example, chapter 72 contains the class of goods relating to the iron and steel. Chapter 73 contains the class of goods related to the article of iron and steel. Chapter 74 contains the class of goods relating to the copper and article thereof. And chapter 75 covers the class of goods related to the nickel and article thereof, etc. After sections and chapters, then comes the heading. Each of the chapters and subchapters is further divided into the various headings, depending on the different class or different type of goods belonging to the same class of product. For example, section 15, which is relating to the base metal and article of base metal, is divided into the chapter. Chapter 72 of base metal and article of base metal is about the iron and steel. That chapter is further divided into the different headings. Headings like pig iron, ferroalloy, and granule and powder, so on and so forth. There are lots of headings which is related to the iron and steel. And the iron and steel is relating to the section 15, which is of the base metal and article of base metal. So this is how the HSN code is divided. First one is the section, which is relating to the broader class of the product, like chapter 15, which is of base metal and article of base metal. Then comes the chapter, which is like in this case is iron and steel. And after that comes the heading. Heading is very specific to the chapter, and chapter is specific to the section. So first one is section, then comes the chapter, and then the heading. Now we should discuss about the rule for interpretation of HSN. The rule is itself provided in the HSN list. It is called the general interpretative rule. And each of the rule is to be applied sequentially. It means that if the first rule, you can't apply the first rule for classification of goods, then only you have to follow the second rule. And if you can't apply the classification of goods by second rule, then you have to follow the third rule. It means that you have to go through sequentially. If your goods is not classified on the basis of rule number 1, then go to rule number 2. If not rule number 2, then only go to the rule number 3. So you have to go through the sequentially. So rule number 1 is that the title of section and chapters are provided only for the ease of reference. For the legal purpose, you have to refer the heading and subheading. So the title of section and chapters is only provided for the ease of reference. It means that you can't follow the title of section and chapters. For legal purpose, you have to refer the heading and subheading for the classification of goods. If you can't classify the goods on the basis of rule number 1, then you have to apply the rule number 2. It says, if the meaning of the word used to describe the product is not clear, then refer to the trade practice. Word that goods is called in the general public. And if the trade understanding of a product can't be established, then find the technical and dictionary meaning of that particular goods. Rule 3 is relating to the unfinished or incomplete goods. If you have the unfinished or incomplete goods and you know the classification of final product, then first of all check that whether unfinished goods have the essential characteristics of the final product. If the unfinished goods has the essential characteristics of the final product, then classify those unfinished or incomplete goods into the category of the final product. So first of all, you have to check that whether the final product, you know the classification of final product, and if yes, then check that whether the unfinished or incomplete goods has the essential characteristics of the finished goods. And If the unfinished or incomplete goods has the essential characteristics of the final goods, then classify the unfinished or incomplete goods on the category of the final product. Rule 4 says that if there is still a confusion in classifying the goods, then find out the which heading is specific and which heading is more general, and prefer the specific heading. Rule 5 says that if the problem is not solved by applying the rule number 4, then find out the which material or component gives the essential character to the goods in question. So if you can't classify the goods on the basis of the step number 4, then step number 5 says that find out which material or component gives the essential characteristic to the goods which are subject to the classification. Rule number 6 says that if both the material and component give the essential characteristics to the goods in question, then find out which material or component comes last in the HSN list and take it. Rule number 7 says that if you are unable to find any entry which matches with your goods in question, then find out those goods which are similar to the goods in question and classify your goods on the basis of that similar good. And lastly, with this our video ends, is rule number 8, which says that the packing material is classified along with the goods, except when the packing material is for the repetitive use. And finally, with this our video ends, is rule number 8, which says that the packing material is classified along with the goods, except when the packing material is for the repetitive use. Thanks for watching my video. If you like it, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can ask the query by sending an email to sharwangst.148@gmail.com. sharwangst.148@gmail.com. The link of the website in which you can find the HSN code is given down in the description. We will meet in the next video. Till then,